In other news, Philippine inflation accelerates to its fastest pace in nearly 14 years. The Consumer Price Index quickened to 7.7% in October from September's 6.9%. October's reading is the highest since December of 2008, driven by a rise in food and power costs. But there could be more pain ahead for consumers. At least one economist says food prices will continue to rise in the coming months due to the agricultural damage caused by severe tropical storm Paeng.
I don't think we are at the peak yet because, you know, there is, we just encountered a major typhoon that affected the whole country. This is a worldwide challenge, particularly if you take a look at cereals and all of those stuff that requires fertilizer, which is really the main reason why there is a supply crunch.
The latest print brings average inflation from January to October to 5.4%, way above government's 2-4% target range. The country's top economist vows to cushion the impact of elevated inflation. Socioeconomic Planning Secretary Arsenio Balisacan says government is committed to providing immediate relief to the most vulnerable sectors in the forms of cash aid and fuel discounts. He also calls for more support for the agriculture sector to sustain its productivity and resilience. The Philippine Central Bank earlier said it will hike interest rates by 75 basis points at its November 17 meeting, matching the U.S. Federal Reserve's latest move in a bid to bring inflation under control. Sugar prices were also one of the reasons why inflation rose in October. Now it may become an even bigger driver of inflation in the coming months as sugar producers from Negros Oriental seek another round of price hikes to help them cope with the impact of severe tropical storm Paeng.
This is quite ironic because we were the very first ones who supported the 70 peso retail price pegged by the president. But now, because of the typhoon Paeng and its destruction, it really hit us bad in our province. Flooded fields, canes went down. We're asking for the help of our kababayans to buy our sugar at 85 to 90 pesos and retail so that it will translate to 60 pesos on our mill gate price. With that, we can keep on planting and putting up the next crop for next year.
Maguindanao officials assure families of those missing in landslides, search and retrieval operations will continue. They clarify only military personnel have wrapped up operations, but the local government and volunteers will continue the search. Seven people remain missing in the province.
Hanggang hindi po namin na kikita ang kanilang mga bangkay, ay hindi po kami mag-give up para hanapin sila. And then looking forward na sana ay natangay lamang sila ng tubig baha at napadpad sa karatig na mga munisipyo. Patuloy din tayong nakikipag-coordinate kahit po sa nearby province, sa province of Sultan Kudarat, kasi magkakatabi lang ating mga coastal areas na baka meron doon na hindi pa nila nare-report na mga napadpad na mga kababayan natin.
Meanwhile, Maguindanao's provincial administrators say a relocation site for those displaced by landslides has yet to be determined.
Nagbago na naman po ang terrain ng ating lugar dahil nga po itong mga dating lugar na hindi pinabaha ay nagkaroon na ng pagbaha at ng mga landslides. So kinakailangan na natin ngayon ng reassessment ng area. Kinakailangan natin ng expert opinion regarding this area. So, kailangan namin humingi ng tulong doon sa ating mga kinauukulan, lalo na po sa national government para matulungan itong ating mga kababayan.
The death toll due to severe tropical storm Paeng now stands at 154. More than half were from the Bangsamoro region.